Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Great Commission Bible Study. We're continuing our series, and we're having testimonies from our overseas mission partners. We had one last week from Brother Wayne Searfoss, and then the week before that, who was a missionary in Mexico and a preacher for 68 years. And then 2 weeks ago, we had Brother Moses from Kenya, and this week we have a dear brother from Bangladesh. It's our mission partner from Bangladesh. His name is Hilton Biswas. We met a few years ago, and I'm not going to talk too much longer here because he's going to tell the story, but it was such a blessing to meet him. As we meet many mission partners, you know, at first sometimes it's a little bit challenging because of doctrine, you know, doctrinal differences or language barrier, but I'll tell you, it's been such a blessing to work with Brother Hilton. We talk all the time, albeit not enough, and he has gone from really 2 years ago just, you know, somebody in the wilderness to somebody now that's literally has a team of 15 or 20 people sometimes that he goes out into the streets, into the villages. And I thank all the people on here, whether you're a financial partner or a prayer partner, you're both just as important. What we've been able to do with Brother Hilton and all our mission partners over the last couple of years could only be done through the Lord Jesus Christ. So I give him every bit of the glory. And I thank everybody for listening tonight and the people that will listen to this recording. I hope this edifies you. We are so grateful for Brother Jeremy, who is our teacher. He has done an outstanding job of teaching us how to go out into the highways and hedges and call people to the Lord Jesus Christ, which is holiness and repentance. It's not the easy gospel that is being taught today. We know that there was is prophesied a great falling away, and that's what's happening. And it's just a breath of fresh air and a huge blessing that I'm able to thank the Lord for somebody like Brother Jeremy and people like Brother Hilton, that we can all work together, all the gears working together. So I'm going to turn it over to Brother Hilton again. He's from Bangladesh, and he's going to take over from here. Thank you so much, Brother Hilton.
Thank you, Brother Jimmy. And praise the Lord. I like to greetings from Bangladesh, all of my brothers and sisters there. And it is really very good opportunity for me from the Bangladesh to share our testimony and our work in the world. And I like to thank Brother Jimmy because last 3 years he's helping me with the word of God and also financially for work in Bangladesh. And I am really sorry to say that because I am not very good in English, because English is not my first language, you know. It was 1984, 29th October. I was born in Gopalganj in Bangladesh. It's a little village and very poor village also. My father was a continental cook. He was working care Bangladesh. And he has a small business in Khulna city. And when I was in 6 years old, he had fallen down his business. And also he lost his job, because the job period was finished. And my family that time was falling down, very big problem. We are moved that time Dhaka from Khulna. And my father, he trying to get a job at Khulna, at Dhaka. But he didn't. After 6 months or more, 1989, he got a job at Dhaka. And last both of years, he worked there and trying to solve the last problem, because he had a business, and we have some problem with financially, and he tried to solve all the problems by his current job. When I was 16 years old, my father was he go Libya, but there was a problem also, because at that time Libya was bracketed by USA, and my father could not send any money. That time my family felt totally a critical moment and a critical situation, and my education stopped. My family facing some problem, big problem, and I joined a big shop for my family's liability, for my family's responsibility. There I was as a helper. After 1 year, my father came back in Bangladesh, but without any money. 2 years he was jobless. In my little income, I was unable to fill my family's needs. Intention, I was drug addicted. I engaged with some bad company. My father got a job after 2 years. Then I stopped my work and I went to school again. But I cannot avoid the drugs because it's already I already addicted. My father, after some days of his last job, he was became sick, and I again my education, my study, all were opted. Again, I find a job, and that time I was 18. Besides my job or work, I learned computer because I have a sub corner about computer. In that day, I work in electrical shop, and in evening time I learn computer, and in night time I do art job because I have idea about some art. So all day I was busy, but after my art work at night, I engaged again with that bad company, bad friends. They called me all time to join a political party. And after some days, I agreed with them and I joined a political political party in Bangladesh. And I do some political activities with them. And was only one, the witness, all of crime of them. One day our government catch our all friends, but they didn't catch me. So they think that I was the only one witness of them. That's why they want to kill me, and they want to treat me every time. And it's very, very afraid for my family also. My father decided to bring us in village because if I live in Dhaka, they will kill me. So we all, with my family, we go to village again. And I start a computer school because already I have the knowledge of a computer. It was really very good time for me. I was 19 years old there that time. I have no sister, but my father, he thinking about my marriage, and he and I married at 2002, 5th October, but I didn't leave the tracks. I saw in village some people in a Christian, they goes to church, but I didn't attend that church. my wife and my family told me all time to get a church, to join Bible study, to join Sunday school, to join Christian people, but I don't like them because, you know, from the beginning, when I realized I didn't see any God in my life, I see only problem. And that time I thought that money is the God, because when I have money, when I have money, I can solve any problem. But I did not realize the God. And after some days of my marriage, I came in again Dhaka for new job. It was 2004 February, and my wife, she get a job here and is school teacher, and I work a computer shop again, and I try to develop myself as a computer engineer. After some days, I have a good opportunity there, and one company, he took me as a computer engineer to their company, and they give me a smart salary, but it is not good enough for me because I have some liability last those years. 2006, 18th August, God gave me a child, my daughter. After 3 years of her born, my company had closed. And again, I came in jobless. It was 2009. 2009 February, I joined the MLM company. And I worked there 2 years. I came from, I income from there some money. My mother asked me, that time I realized, my mother asked me, that is, God provide me that money because He prayed all time for me, and my Lord heard her prayer. I believe that time because from the very beginning of my life, I faced many problems, have no any time when I faced God and prayed to Him for me and my family. But I believe my mother because every critical situation in our family, my mother's prayer saved us from all distraction. When she prayed, I saw tears all time in her eye. He was praying to Lord for us. He had a prayer power. I feel that. All time she pray for us and she cry for us and she cry to Lord. And in this situation, I also saw she thanks to Lord also. But I did not understand why she thanks to Lord. Because we are in problem, we are facing problem, but why she thanks in Lord? But she told me that we have to thank Lord in any situation because she loves us. He loves us. So, in 2010, I will try to get a school, try to start a school for poor children because I cannot study for financial problem, my family problem. So I tried, but did not avoid the drugs. But my mother's prayer, and he realized to convince me to Lord. And when 2010 in February, I joined a theology college, and I completed a short Bible course in 3 months. And that time I realized the God word, and He loved me. And I tried to avoid all my drugs and all my bad activities. When I complete the short course of Bible study, I realized that this is the only way wherefrom I can get salvation and where and my Lord can help me to work, to get my perfect work. My MLM company was closed, my computer business also closed, everything is closed, but my mother told me that is an exam for us, because he want to know that, my Lord want to know that I am really believing or not. And I decided I will work for God. And I start again Bible theory study and start my ministry for children and youths. From the beginning of my belief in Lord, it is a miracle that I have no problem. I have no any sadness in my life after when I believe God. I feel very happiness, and I and my family also very happy. My wife, my father, my mother, my brother, they are very happy when I start ministry and when I start Bible study again, because my heavenly Lord touched me and he showed me the true way. But the situation was not very good, because in our Bangladesh Christian, or when from I complete the theology, it was not a right doctrine. And I faced problem in my mentally. And I think that is not correct. And I asked prayer to Lord again. But my Lord, he touched me and he showed me one man who is selected for us, for Bangladesh and for me, that is Brother Jimmy. It was August 2013. My Lord introduced me with Brother Jimmy from via Facebook. And when I meet with him, I realized that there is something different what I learned before. And I asked him firstly to teach me about the real doctrine, about the true doctrine. And he tried to contact with me sometime with the Bible study, with some teaching, and with some papers was, he sent me by an email, and I studied it mindly. After 2 months, he asked me some papers about my legality. And I sent him, and that is all my legality, what is here, my driving license, my national ID cards, theology certificate, and everything I sent to him. And that is a miracle for me. He decided to help me. He decided to sponsor me. And I realized that is the true gospel mission, what is starting with us from Brother Jimmy. I thank the Lord, and I started the ministry. And I named it Trinity Bangladesh, because I believe in Trinity, and Brother Jimmy encouraged me about it. And from that day till now, I'm working with Brother Jimmy. And here, Global Mission for Children, every time helping us for our ministry, for our work, where we are going and where we are doing anything. It's all for Brother Jimmy and Global Mission for Children. Brother Marvin also there, and Sister Susan, and everybody. They are trying to contact me all time, and they're teaching me all time, and they advise me, and mostly every day and night, they are praying for me, because I am alone here. You know, last year, 2014, when I was in Ghazipur, that was very crucial moment for me, because I work in there in gospel mission, I try to share the gospel in unreached people. After 6 months, the people are trying to kill me because they didn't like the Lord, they didn't believe in God, they didn't believe in Jesus Christ. But I told them about Him, about Jesus Christ, about salvation, about the gospel, but they do not understand. They tried to kill me. And all time, the Muslim peoples are around me. My really, that time was really problem. And I told Brother Jimmy and all of my friends in abroad, they prayed for me, and Brother Jimmy especially, he helped me from Global Mission for Children's Ministry. He helped me to out from there. And I came out from there in Khulna. And now I presently at Khulna. Here I am working. Global Mission. Totally, I have here totally now 6 volunteers. My wife and I have Sunday school here. What is under my wife? She is teaching there, and I have a school. We have a school here for the poor children, street children. My wife and I have another volunteer. He is teaching there also, and we have 6 field here. It is Boitagatha and Golamari, Chenati, Chandani Mahal, and Appeal Gate and Fulbari Gate. We have 6 fields here, and we have a big Bible study school here. We have 20 youths who are joining with us, who are doing class with us, and we are teaching them about the gospel and about the true gospel and about the true doctrine. And Brother Jimmy and Global Mission for Children helping us, and also of all of my brothers from Facebook, and they also advise me how to bring the class and how to teach them. And I follow their teaching, I follow the lessons, I follow Brother Jimmy's lesson, I teach them one of all those lessons. We have the gospel missions. I and my brothers, we go the missions for the gospel sharing. We visit some villages here every month, regularly in 3 or 4 villages, a new village, new people. We go door to door. We visit man to man. We share the gospel in them. We asking their problem, and we praying pray for them. And all of them, we have a partner also here. His brother Shanto, he also work with us, and he preach the gospel in his field because he have a big field there. And we help also them, with financially and logistical support, everything. And brother Shanto, he's really a good brother because he is also from Muslim. He is converted. He believe in Lord, and he came out from the Muslim in Christian. And last in 2 or 3 months, we are start a project here. We take a land for rent, and here we planting some vegetables for our volunteers family, because you know Bangladesh is very expensive, so that's why we are trying to plant the vegetable what will help us. And also we are trying to start a goat project here because it is very profitable business for Bangladesh. Brother Jimmy and Brother McClum and other brothers who are going to helping us for this project. And very soon, I hope, and we are praying, very soon we are starting the good project, and it will help us for our mission partners for our volunteers' family, because we cannot give them any honorarium, we cannot give them any financial support. They are all work with me totally free, but they have family, they have education, they have their own liability. So we have to pay some honorarium to them. That's why we are trying to start this project where we can give some honorarium from this profit. And also we have a sponsorship project, Brother Jimmy and Global Mission for Children are helping us for this sponsorship project. Currently we have 44 children here who are already listed, and about 20 plus children already sponsored. And end of this year, we are trying to complete in 100 our children list. And very soon, we will send our new children data and all to Brother Jimmy for listed there in the mission list. And that is all. And currently, I am working in gospel mission, and I am sharing my testimony, all of my people. When I go to preach the gospel, I share my testimony to them, because they have to know where from my Lord bring me, and where from my Lord touch me, and where from my Lord save me. I told them, and they believe it, and they feel very interested, because this is new for them, because they are Hindu and Muslim. So, brothers and sisters, all of you, I request you, please pray for me and pray for our missions in Bangladesh, what I am doing here. And I believe your prayers and support will help us to continue our work and to continue being the success and to continue share the gospel in our people, and we can bring out people from the wrong doctrine. We can bring people from the flesh. We can give them the salvation. Amen. Thank you.
Wow. Thank you very much, Brother Hilton. I know we're going to have a lot of questions tonight, so please hang on for a second. Guys and ladies and sisters and brothers, before we get into the questions and answers, I just wanted to let you guys know that we've had to move Brother Hilton multiple times in the last couple of years because of death threats and whatnot. So the reason for that is he lives in a predominantly Muslim country. Bangladesh is 86.6% Muslim, 12.1% Hindu, 0.6% Buddhist, and 0.4% Christian. So only 4 out of 1,000 people in Bangladesh are Christian. Almost 87 out of 100 are Muslim. So I know there's a lot of stuff going around in the news these days, and Muslims seem to be on the front pages of the paper. But we have a dear brother here that is laboring day and night right in the middle of millions of them. And we just praise the Lord for his zeal and his boldness. And he goes door to door. He has no fear at all. Him and his team go out right in to the villages and the cities, and he has touched so many people. So I'm going to just let it be open here and let the questions go.
Hey, Brother Jimmy, are we unmuted?
Yeah, I never muted it, brother, because I can't mute because Sarah called, remember?
Because... Okay, well, yeah, that's great, and I'm glad everything sounded really perfect on my end, so I'm glad we didn't run into any problems. Seems like the Lord really blessed us there with a
yep.
very good quality, so I'll go ahead and ask. It's kind of a two-part question with Brother Hilton. I know we've discussed it a little bit privately, but if you could... tell a little bit, brother, of the difference, say, with the violence and the militant nature of the Muslims there I think we know at least a little bit that it's not, that you have, although a lot of suppression, Christian ministry, a little bit more freedom than, say, maybe being in Iran or something, some of the Middle East where they're just literally getting every Christian in sight is fleeing or they're being murdered. Or if you could speak to a little bit, if you could compare maybe the level of violence or the way that most Muslims are there to the way they are in the worst parts of the world, say, in the East. And then if you could talk about what would be the difference when you witness to a Muslim versus a Hindu, as you said before that they're Muslim and Hindu mostly that are hearing you. You do that, you approach it pretty much the same, or what would be maybe the difference of some things that you deal with based on that? Did my question make sense?
Yes, hello?
Yes, did you hear my question?
Did you understand that, Brother Hilton?
Okay, good. Yes, that's it. Yes, brother. Thank you. Thank you for your question, brother. Actually, Bangladesh is a Muslim country, as brother Jimmy says, because here is only 0.4% are Christian. So we are very minority here. Muslims are really very dangerous for us, but not like that in Hindu. Hindu also here. But they are not violent like the Muslims. Last in my team, last 10 years, the Muslims are became more aggressive, more violent for the Christians, because the Christian world, you know, because now is the digital age. Everybody know the news from the internet or the television or the satellite. That's why the Muslim people of Bangladesh, they know about the Christians in other countries. And that's why they are really very aggressive. That's why really very dangerous for Christians. That they see, they're seeing that Christians are converting Muslims. They see the Christians are trying to convince Muslims. So that's why they think that in Bangladesh also, the Bangladesh people who is in Christian, they also working that work. That's why they are trying to stop them. Sometimes they become in violence, they try to kill. In presently, you know, last month, here one pastor from Dinajpur, I know him very well, he attacked, and some people are trying to kill him because he's sharing the gospel. And you know, 2002, there was a big boom blast in a Catholic church in our village. And also, and many, many of them, last two or three days, I will send you the link, last 2 or 3 days, there is a very threat, a big threat from the Muslims by the mobile. They are calling the Christian pastors, and they're asking them to stop all of this gospel work. They're asking them all to stop any Christian work. Another, they will kill them. And they send the message from mobile that if we do not stop our work, they will kill us. My Christian partners in Bangladesh, my brothers, who are working with us, and also my friends who are working in gospel mission. They are, all time we are in problem, all time we are in facing this problem, that they, when they will come to us and they will attack us, we cannot get out lonely. We all time we take our people with us, because we don't know what will happen in next, in out. That is the problem. I feel last year when I was in Gazipur, I told my testimony. When I was in Gazipur, that time also, they come to my home, the Muslim people, about 20 or 25. They come to my home and they knock me, they call me out because they want to hit me, they want to kill me. But my Lord saved me. So I believe this is not a problem because my Lord died for us, died for our sin. So we have to die for him. We have need to die for him. So I am not afraid about it because I believe in Lord and he will save me. Thank you.
Wow. Praise the Lord, brother.
Amen.
Having trouble even speaking after hearing you testify to that. And we thank God for your boldness and being a true witness, you know, in Acts, the book of Acts, where the beginning where Jesus said, told the disciples what would happen when the Holy Ghost comes upon them, and he said, you'll be my witnesses, first in their area, Judea, Samaria, and so forth, where they were, and then all the ends of the earth, and that word. That word in the original text in the Greek language, witnesses, is martos, and it's where we derive the word martyr, and that's exactly what you're describing as your testimony, brother, that you've already counted the cost, even if it's your life, and we just are so thankful for that, brother, and my part two of that question, if I might reiterate, and hopefully folks would like to hear this, is could you speak to a little bit of the difference when you're speaking to Hindus as opposed to when you're speaking to the Muslim people to preach Christ to them? Are there some differences because of their differing religions that you have to deal with, or do you just basically keep it the same basic gospel message, or are there different things? Maybe you could share some of the differences there.
Yeah. Sorry, thank you.
Does that make sense? You... What?
Did you hear that revelation? Yes.
Okay, good. Yeah, he's asking just, do you use a different technique when preaching to a Muslim versus a Hindu?
Yes. Actually, there is a little difference. That is, when I go to Hindus for the gospel, I told them about the salvation, and I told them about the repentance, because they are doing the idol worship. So there is no problem. They understand, and they want to understand more, want to learn more. But when I go to Muslims, they are not convinced, because, you know, we Christian and Muslim have some similarity, because in their Quran, they have also Moses, they have also Noah, they have also Abraham, and they have also everything in like us, in our Bible. That they have some similarity also, but they do not believe in Christ. They do not believe that is Christ is Son of God and He is the God. They do not believe it. That's why when we told them that Christ is Lord, and He is the Son of God, they do not agree with us. And that time, they came out very angry. And we apply another technique. We told them that my Lord Jesus Christ will come again for us for our salvation, but they do not believe it. Sometimes they agree with us to understand what we are going to say, but actually they are not coming up with belief. Thank you, brother.
That is very, very good, brother. If I may ask a question, which I think will be very relevant, which I think will be very relevant for the recording and everybody on here, of course, too, is we do have the children's program. You know, $15 a month, you can sponsor a child and have that connection with them. It's a very spiritual connection. You can email them and you translate. And I love seeing that go back and forth. That's just a miracle from God to see people thousands of miles away writing letters to each other, you know. But I also want to let everybody on this call and the recording know that you also go out, of course, into the mission field. That's of course, the Great Commission. And I just wanted you to highlight, brother, I just want to let everybody know that Brother Hilton reached out to me back in early August, I believe, and he says, I want to go on a mission trip with 10 or 11 missionaries. And I'm very, very careful on how we spend the hard-earned money and the blessings that we get from the Lord through his saints of God. So I'm thinking in my mind that 10 people going on a mission trip, they needed to go on a bus, they needed to rent a private boat, they needed a guard. They were going to the Sundarban region of Bangladesh, which is the largest mangrove in the world. It's a very beautiful area, but however, they worship, there's Hindus and Muslims there, I believe, and probably other of these false religions. It's probably one of the most spiritually wicked places in the world because of all that witchcraft. You know, they worship tigers, they worship trees, they worship snakes, they worship everything but the Lord Jesus Christ. And so Hilton, in his boldness with the Holy Spirit, of course, asked if we could, get him some funds to go there. So I'm thinking this is going to cost, you know, an extraordinary amount of money and we wouldn't be able to do it. And he comes back, and he does a very, very great job of being accountable for the funds that we give him. So he line items everything, the boat, the guard, the bus trip and this and that. And then they brought, I think, you can go into it, Hilton, but I think that will edify us. We just go through that process and what just this one particular outreach and you just for 5 minutes on how that worked and what your travels were.
Thank you, brother. Actually, that was a really very great mission for us because that is the first long mission trip for us here, our ministry. That was Sundarban, and it was very, very, very good mission for us. You know, the Sundarban is the largest mangrove in the world, and it is in Bangladesh. And before going Sundarban, I told my all volunteers together that we have to do something different. We have to go in very deep of our jungle, because there is many people who are worshipping idol god, who are worshipping eternal god, because they are worshipping their tigers, snakes, the sun, the trees, and also the born baby. Human born baby, she was a human, and the local people are worship her. So we decide that we will go there to preach and to share the gospel in them, because they have made the salvation. That's why my team, we have 12 members, and some of in our Bible study group. So we go there, and Brother Jimmy and another of my from my friends, they helped me. They fund us to go there. And we bring, we take some foods for the children, because we cannot do anything directly without any support, because if they they are very poor, the people, if we give them something, they will hear us, they will listen us, but we cannot talk with them without anything, because they do not like Christians, you know. That's why we take some food for their children. We go there. Firstly, we hired a bus from here to Monglapur, and then we hired a private boat, and we take two guards from the government, because that place is not very good. There is the jungle's problem, animals' problem, and also the human problem, because there are many people who live in jungle. They catch the people and they ask money. That's why we take some we take two guards with us, and we go the last part of Bangladesh, the last human part of Bangladesh, and the last village, and it is deep in jungle, and we go there when we call first and the children to come came out us, and we give them, and their parents also come to us, and we told them that we are Christian, we came here for the gospel, and they welcome us, and we talk about the God, about the gospel, and about our mission, and they are very happy, because you know they are Muslim and Hindus, but they have no anyone who can help them. But we told them we will help them, we will preach in them, and we will sponsor their children, we will help their children for education, for health, and everything. That's why they are agree with us to hear our gospel. So we call them all together, and we share the gospel in them, and that time we got some two or three people who are sick, and we prayed for them at a time. And also we go to door to door, man to man, and we call them out and we pray for them. And that was really, really very, very good mission and success mission. But you know, one problem also there, that is we have no enough food there, because there is no shop, there is no anything. Where can we buy the food for us? That is a problem. And another big problem was when we came out jungle, a big storm. Suddenly a big storm started there, and it was really very dangerous. And that time we also in the river, the big river in Bangladesh, that is Poshur. We in the river, my wife and two women also with us, two girls. So they are crying, but my team, my children, my youth, they start prayer, and we pray in this storm, and my Lord save us, and that is a miracle for us. That is prayer save us. We are really very thankful to Lord, because for this mission, and thankful to Brother Jimmy and Global Mission for Children to complete this mission. Thank you.
I just wanted to finish there before the next question. That entire mission with two guards, a private boat, I think you had 70 or 100 bags for the children, brother, of food and stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. That's 100 bags of food, guys. It cost $300 total. And
yes,
I can't tell you how many people heard that gospel in one of the most remote areas of the world. It's just amazing. I mean, we can't go into a big city and stay at a hotel for one night for $300 in this country we call America. But they were able to get 11 people down there and to preach the gospel. And it was just, it brought tears to my eyes when I saw the pictures and the testimonies. Because these people, I mean, this is one of the most spiritually wicked places in the world, and I just praise the Lord, Hilton, for your obedience to the Lord and the way you preach. So we're going to be wanting to send you there again too, and we'll certainly do that as soon as we can raise the funds. So
ask some more questions while we have Brother Hilton on.
All right, I'm going to ask another question. Brother, what is the greatest need that you have as a ministry now? What are the greatest prayer needs that you have also, the greatest financial needs? Just please enlighten us on those type of things, if you would.
Thank you, brother. Actually, in my life, if I say, I have no need anything, only I have need your prayers. Because I believe God will provide everything through you or others. But prayer, this is the mostly important donation for us. So I ask to all my friends, to you, that pray for us and our ministry, because it is need for our Bangladesh. We have to continue our gospel mission. Financial support, it is not important for us. Our important is the prayer, and important is the teaching, because you know I am joining every class, or I download the classes and I learning every day. I hear that class every day, and I teach my people also the classes. So my people and me, we have need the prayers and financial things. I believe in some, it is not good enough. We have need prayers. Thank you, brother.
God bless you, brother.
Amen.
Anything you want to add, Brother Jeremy? Any more questions?
I was just so blessed and amazed at what the Lord, brother, and especially when you were speaking of the time when the big group came to your house, and you said something like 20 or 30 Muslims came to your house, and God saved your life through that. I was wondering if you would mind telling us in as much detail as possible what exactly happened. You know, I mean, because we imagine these people, they want to come and grab you and take you out, just like they did with Stephen in the book of Acts in chapter 7. They drew him out of the city and killed him, you know. And so I'm imagining when you're telling that's what these people came to bust into your house and take you. Can you describe in detail when what they did, and then what was the breaking point where I guess you saw just the Spirit of God somehow, or the angels, you know, that are camped around you that we can't see, somehow they moved upon the situation and the men left or whatever. Can you explain exactly what happened?
Yes. Thank you, brother. Actually, it was a very important part of my life. And I thank God for this lesson. You know, when I was at Daribu,
Brother Hilton, hold on.
Yes.
Brother Hilton, hold on 1 second. See if you could start over, because that was getting a little choppy there. So please start that answer over again.
Yes, sure. Actually, it was really very, very important part of my life. When I was in Gazipur, I worked the doctor mission in the Muslim people, because they are totally Muslim area. Totally about 40 or 50 villages they are there. They are totally Muslim. So I go to door-to-door, mentor-to-mentor, and I introduce with new people because I am also there new. So I introduce with new people and I trying to say them about the gospel. I trying to share the gospel. And day by day, when I am known in them, they are want to asking about me, what I am doing, what is my mission, and what is my job, because they see that I have no job. I am only traveling village to village. So directly first time they did not come to me. They called with my house owner where I was in rent. And they contact with them. They are from the local mosque. You know the mosque, the masjid. They are from the local mosque, the Muslim people. They go to the my house owner and ask him about me. So my house owner, he told me about me that I am Christian and I am doing their the Christian job. Because they do not know what is the call of this job. That's why I say they told them that it is a Christian job. So first time and second time, third time, they come to him, my house owner, but they didn't. They cannot meet with me because when they come, that time I was in field. Or I was in outside. That's why they cannot meet with me. But one day, it was at night, I am at home. And unfortunately, my house owner, he come to me, knock my door. And I opened the door. He called me, are you alone? I told them, no, I am not alone. My wife and my children, my child is here. So he called me, you have some visitors here. So I told him who is them, and he told me that he is they are from the local mosque. They want to talk with you. So I told them okay, let them come in. So but they do not want to come in. They call me outside. So my wife, she was very afraid because you know she is a lady. So that's why she was very afraid. So that's why he didn't want to go me outside. But I told her that is call from God. I have to go out. I have to call talk with them. And my wife, she began the prayer, and I go outside with my house owner. And when I saw there was 20 or 25. People and all of them are Muslim, and they are all the eyes of them on me, and I saw in their eyes they are very angry on me, and they told me what I am doing here. I have to stop this war and I have to leave this area, another they will kill me. So sometimes I was afraid, but in mentally and in hardly, I start the prayer because I know I have need God in that time because only God can save me. And this is the miracle. My house owner, he is really a good man. He stopped them and he told them that is, I will talk with Brother Hilton. And he will not do anything here again about the Christian world. And he saved me from those people. He also Muslim, but he saved me because he know me. And I shared the gospel in the, also to them. And he believed the gospel. That's why he saved me from there. And he told them that Brother Hilton will not do any work here. He will do another, but he will not do any work near our house. And that time they are go. And after that night, the morning they come again. and they forced me, why you are still here? You have to go from here. And I told them, I will go from here. I will not live here. Weekly, total, every day they come to me and they forced me. And when I go to out, there are people behind me. When I go to the market, there are people also behind me. So it is really very trouble for me, make very trouble for me. And my wife, she works a school. They go to school also, and they forced their principal to sack my wife, and she lost her job also because she's Christian. So this is really very trouble for us, and my children, my child, she also read in school, and she also dropped it from there. So that is really very dangerous for us. And I ask Brother Jimmy, and I ask Brother all of his friends for prayer and help to bring out from there to me. And they help us, and now I am at Khulna. Thank you.
Powerful, brother. Really, really powerful. You know, most of us that are on this phone call, and I guess I don't speak to every single one, but, you know, we have homes in a developed country that is comfortable. We just open up our refrigerator and grab, you know, sometimes it's a decision, right? Am I going to grab an apple or an orange, or do I get this to drink or that? Or we have the luxury of having herbs and vitamins at our leisure, you know. I don't know if I'm going to get through this. That's not the case overseas, you know. And I just want to really have everyone pray for our missionaries, and including Hilton. His wife has been quite sick lately. Actually, she's been sick on and off for almost the whole time that I've known Brother Hilton. And that's why it's so important, everybody. If we're following Christ, we are commanded to take care of the least of these, my brethren. And Hilton is certainly one of those people, and also who he works with, and the mission teams over there. So it's just so very important. We don't understand that $10, $20, $30 a month goes so far to help these people. And we also thank our sponsors that have really gone over and above what I would imagine. We're a very small ministry, but I'll tell you, talking to these guys on a daily basis and listening to these stories, the good ones and the bad ones, you know, there's challenging ones, right, where you have to move in the middle of the night, you know, and we don't have to do that. And, you know, a lot of people think that America is a blessing. Well, I'm telling you, it's a curse, because too much is given, much is required, and I fear for the souls of a lot of people that don't give enough. You know, they see these things on the TV, maybe on a passing commercial, and well, it's over there. Or I hear this all the time, that the government should take care of that, or the people in that country should take care of that. Well, the Lord Jesus talked about how we're to take care of the poor or the widow and the orphan just about more than any other subject in the Bible. So I just want to exhort everybody that after listening to this incredible testimony from Brother Hilton, that we really heed that call that the Lord is calling you and tugging on your conscience to give more. I absolutely, although I've been a salesman all my life, and very successful at times, I hate asking for money, and we'll leave it at we're asking for your prayer. So any other questions?
All right.
Brother Hilton, is there anything else that you or your team in specific want us to pray for, or anything else that you wanted to add before we finish our call here? Enough for your time. Believe me when I tell you, this testimony, not just live here on the call, but the recording,
will touch more lives than you can count. So we give all the glory to Jesus Christ, and I really thank you for taking your early morning hours here to talk to us and to give us that update. But if anybody else has any questions, if not, Brother Hilton, anything else you want to add?
Yes. Thank you, brothers. Actually, I want to add now, with your permission, that is, you know, last year we distribute for our fields, new fields and old fields. And now is winter season, and it is really very dangerous for Bangladesh, you know, because Bangladesh people are very poor, and they are not able to buy the blankets for the winter. So that's why we are trying to provide some blankets this year also. So I am requesting all of my friends and all of my brothers and sisters to please pray for our this mission, because maybe within December 15, we will provide 200 blankets, and including to our sponsored children also, because we have now listed, in our mission listed 84 children. So that's why we are adding them also in our this mission. So we are trying to collect 200 blankets for our mission field in Bangladesh. We have six fields here. So I request through Brother Jimmy to you all that please pray for this our this mission, blankets mission, and trying to help us to complete our mission. And now I am really very, very grateful to my Lord to give me this opportunity to introduce you with you and share my testimony and share my ministry testimony to you all. And I am really very thankful to you all for your time to hear me. And I am really very thankful to Brother Jimmy and Global Mission for Children for this opportunity. I am really very happy with you in this moment, and I wish and I hope that God with you all time, and I pray all time for you, for your bright future. And I am really asking to you, please pray for us, pray for our Bangladesh, pray for our mission. God bless you.
Thank you, Brother Hilton. Thank you, everybody, for listening to this call tonight.